In this video, we're going to learn how to manage our components and navigate around the Elements panel. We'll learn how we can restructure our components, add new elements to those components, and even create new components. We're going to start off in Codux with this music application, where if we start to interact around, we see that we have some dynamic states. But ultimately, what we want to do is manage the components inside of this project and even add some new ones. If I navigate back to the Home tab, I can see all the different components I have available in this project, including the album, which if I click and navigate through, I can see a preview of that particular component. This particular view is going to be our board view, where if I go ahead and select this album board, I can see I get some new options, including the properties, where I can start to change things like props, including if I wanted to update the artist name to something like Colby Fayok, we can see it immediately update for this particular preview. Now, if I wanted to edit the component itself, I can head up to my Elements panel and I can select the Edit Component option where I can see all the different elements that compose this particular component, including what seems to be a card component that wraps all the children that are available inside, including a title, artist, and conditionally an image. Now, say for instance, I want to start to edit some of the styles of this component, and in particular, I want to edit the drop shadow and replace it with a border. If I head up to this preview option, I can see that a little bit more clearly, but instead of actually editing this component, it looks like I need to edit the card component. So what I'm going to do is select the edit button of the card component, where if I select the root div in the elements panel, I can start to see all the properties associated with that particular div wrapper, including going to the styles panel where I can change any style I want. But once I'm done, I can see that I'm pretty happy with how this looks for this single view, but I want to look at it compared to the rest of the album. So if I navigate back up to the app tab, I can see exactly how that looks with all of the different albums in place. Now heading back to the album tab, what if I wanted to switch up how some of these elements are placed inside of this component? Such as, what if I wanted to move the artist above the actual album title? Switching back to select mode, we can see that as I'm hovering over all these elements, I get boxes that show what elements are that I can select. If I go ahead and select the title, we can see that as I open up the different panels, I get all the options pertaining to that title. But what I want to do is move this below the artist name. So I'm going to simply drag this below, and we can see that we get that blue bar there that designates where I'm going to drop it. And once I drop it, we can see that I now have it underneath the artist name. Now, I think I actually prefer the title above the artist name, so I'm going to hit Command Z and just undo that change. Now, if we start to look inside the Elements panel at all the different elements available, we see we have some special items, including the children, condition, and we even get something called an expression. Starting with condition, this is going to give us the ability to show something whether it's true or false. Where in our example here, we're going to dynamically show this music icon based off of if something is playing. We can see that this currently isn't showing, meaning it's currently false, meaning it's not rendering anything to the page. If we navigate up to the album board, we can start to look at the properties, where if we set this is playing Boolean to true, we can now see that music note. That's because our condition now sees that as true, so it's rendering the content based off of that condition. If we want to see exactly how that works, we can right-click the element inside of our Elements panel and select View Code, where we can see exactly what's making this display, where in this case, it's the isPlaying property that's defined on the component. As another similar example, I can head back up to the App tab, where inside of my player, what if I wanted to turn this into a new component? Inside of my project home, I'm going to go ahead and select new component where I can define what I want this new component to be called, such as now playing, where I'm going to go ahead and click create. Codux scaffold my component, complete with some example text, as well as a board that I can use to configure how I preview this particular component. Now, to start to try to recreate my now playing component, the first thing I want to do is add some text. So I'm going to go back to the Elements panel and I'm going to select Add Elements, where I'm going to look for the paragraph tag, where once I find that, I'm going to drag that right into my div root. But now we probably don't need this other text node, so I'm going to go ahead and right click it and I'm going to click Delete Element. I'm also going to update the text inside of my paragraph just to something simple, such as artist name, just so that we have an idea of where we're starting from. One of the nice things with Codux is not only do we get access to all the basic elements, we can also configure external libraries, where I configured a few React icons, where I can now take my headphones and drag that right into my component. So not only can I drag around things on the stage, I can head over to my Elements panel and drag those headphones into the paragraph tag there. Now, I want to make sure that this looks good, so what I'm going to do is select my paragraph tag and head over to the Styles panel where I need to create a new class. So I'm going to go ahead and click Create or Apply New Class. I'm going to call this Playing I'm going to create that class, where now, once I create it, I have access to add any styles that I want. Now, I went ahead and added the styling needed, but let's start to think about how we can actually make this dynamic. Now, as we saw before, if we right-click this element and click View Code, we can see that code right inside of Codux. But if I instead want to actually edit this inside of VS Code, I can right-click that and click Open in VS Code. This will open the right file in the right location that I need to have extra flexibility for being able to work with the actual code inside of my natural IDE environment. So we know that we need to add some dynamic data to this. So we can head back up to our props, where the first thing I'm going to do is add my artist, which I'm going to make a string, but then we also have our title, which is similarly going to be a string. I'm going to then add my artist and title props. And to make sure that we're reproducing this component the same as the original code, we can see that we had the artist hyphen title. So I'm going to do the same and set up my artist hyphen title. Now, if we head back to the component, we can see that we no longer have that text in the preview. But as we know before, we can head back up to our board, where we now have access to the board elements, where if we start to modify the properties, we can set an artist of Colby Fayok. We can add a title of Super Cool Album, where we now have that preview available whenever we're editing that component. Now, to actually add this to my project, I'm going to head back over to the app tab, where I'm going to select add elements. I'm going to go to project library components, where I can see all the components that I have available, or I can alternatively search for now playing, where I find my component and I can now drag that into the app. Now, if we want to start to set some values for that, if we head over to the properties panel, we can see that we can start to set some of these props to see what they look like. So if we start to set the artist, we use Colby Fayok again. If we use a title of Cool Album Mix, we can see that it starts to pop up. Now, as we probably realize, we don't want these to be static values. We want them to be based off the state. So if we see this little Codux icon when we hover over the prop, we can click it and it pops it up right inside of Codux, where we can start to grab our original values of the playing.artist. And I can go ahead and replace that. I can also replace my playing.title, and we can see that they start to pop up. Now, the only issue is this isn't currently utilizing the conditional statement in order to only show if it's playing. So what I'm going to do is first get rid of the old component, and then I'm going to replace it with the new now playing component. We can see that it doesn't show, but if I start to open up the interactive mode and click on an album, we can see that it's playing. But with just a few clicks, we were able to see how we were able to easily manage our existing component and even add new components right inside of the Codux editor. Codux brings some powerful ways for how we can visually edit and manage our components right inside of a UI. If you haven't yet tried out Codux, make sure you head over to the Codux website and try it for free. And if you like this video, make sure you hit thumbs up and subscribe for more Codux tutorials, tips, and tricks.